I got broads in Atlanta, just the lean in the family, credit cards in the scammers, hitting the licks in the family, legacies, family, way see, look like a panda, going on like
branding. So we've talked about the ownership model, but one of the other things that you've been able to do is cut out the middleman.
Right.
Forbes lists you as the 53rd highest paid celebrity of the year. If you look at the list, one of the things that really sets you apart is that you're not on the list because of a sport that you play or acting or producing. It is, as the trades call you, a multi-hyphenate. You have so many projects going on at once, they all add up. When there's so many things you could be doing, how are you picking what projects that you want to take on? What do you want to launch? What are you saying no to? How do you make that decision?
You know, it's hard for me to say no. And it always has been. So I've always been this person who takes on a lot. And because I love so many things. I love acting. I love making movies. I also love making television. I love, you know, performing live. I love doing concerts. I love making music. I love being in the studio. So there's so many, when opportunities come, it's hard for me to say no. But what I think I've learned and what I'm trying to do now at this point in my life is to say no a little bit more and hone it down to like working smarter instead of working all the time, which was, you know, it gets tiring.
Right. Yeah.
Everybody's like, so how do you do it? And I'm like, please stop asking me that question because I don't know. And at some point, it's going to catch up with me.
So how are you saying no?
It's really about the quality of the projects, like I said, and knowing which ones are going to have the best ROI, right? And so first, I have to love it and respond to it. And creatively, the artist in me has to be singing, but also, you know, not taking on something that's going to take up 7 months and yield this much.
Right.
And then my whole year is gone. And then I have to like scramble to like make up, you know, everything, you know, the deficit in other ways and with a lot of other projects that don't give me as much passion. And it's been a transitional time, a learning curve over the years. And now I'm at a place where I'm really much more particular. And force myself, as much as I love doing so much, to say no to the smarter things. That changed too when I had my kids.
Your career path, as I think if you look back, you're incredibly successful, done a lot of amazing things. But you've had ups and downs in your career.
Oh, yeah.
When you think back to those downs, is this the kind of thing that has a hangover effect on you where you're like, oh, I don't ever want to go through that again? How do you use those points in your career which weren't great?
You know, I look at them now and I think you really just plowed through those, you know, and that's the thing. It's like you can't stop. You have to kind of keep on going. Failure is not falling down and making a mistake or choosing the wrong movie or doing the wrong thing at the wrong time. It's stopping. Stopping is the failure. Not continuing forward is the failure, not keeping going. And so we don't listen to our gut enough telling us this is not the right thing for you right now. You're doing this out of fear instead of out of love. That's usually when winds up in misery. That's the thing I think that is the best thing to think about in those moments. It's like, am I doing this because I'm afraid of something, or am I doing this because of love? And usually that'll set you on the right path.
You must have people asking you all the time how to be the next Jennifer Lopez. What kind of career advice do you give people?
You know, it's hard because there is no one set path for any one successful person. Like, I feel like everybody takes a different path. Like, there's no actors that I talk to that go, oh, we all started at acting school, and then from there we did plays, and then from plays we went to television. There's, like, no one way to do it. You know, I started as a dancer, and then I thought I was going to do Broadway, and I didn't, and I did some tours abroad, and then I came back here, and I got a job as fly girl on In Living Color, and then I started studying acting, and then from there, I got my first television show, my first development deal, and then from there, I got my first movie, and there was a process to it that I couldn't have predicted or planned or have said, I'm going to do this, 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 and this. It just all happened the way it happened. And I think all you can do is know where you want to go and take steps every single day in that direction, whatever that is, getting better at what you do. And I think that gets you there. Where that will take you, I cannot tell you. But I do know that if you just wake up every day and go, this is what I'm going to do, this is what I'm going to be, and today this is the thing that I'm doing to kind of keep going in that direction, eventually you will get there.
Do you think that your character in the movie does that?
I think that she's given up a little bit. I think she's gotten to the point in her life where she's been at this, you know, value club shop for 15 years. And for 6 years, she's been the assistant manager. And she knows she deserves a promotion. And she's made the store better. And she adds all this value. And at the end of the day, she's looked over by somebody who has a, you know, an Ivy League degree. And that really is her last blow. And I know I've had that in my career. And that was after I was successful. So that is a really true, honest thing that everybody can relate to, of where you get stuck, you know, and almost give up.
So is there one particular takeaway you want people to have when they leave the theaters?
I think my favorite thing that people have said is that they leave the theater inspired. Mm. They leave the theater inspired. And that's my favorite thing about being an artist in general, is that you can inspire people to dream their own biggest dreams.
That's great. Well, Jennifer, thank you very much for joining
us.
This is terrific.
Thank you so much.